like bad. Now I'm done. Thank you, and how are you? Well, I got y'all up now. I'm gonna bring you down. Sing you a sad song, but you like sad songs, don't you? And I write a lot of them. Some of them just plumb pitiful. And this might be one of them, but I love sad songs myself. Well, I've had to think up a way to survive since you said it's over, told me goodbye. And I just can't make it one day without you, unless I pretend the opposite's true. There's snow in the tropics, there's ice on the sun. It's hot in the Arctic, and crying is fun. Oh, but I'm happy now, and I'm glad we're through. And the sky is green, and the grass is blue. Pretty as an angel from the day that she was born. Skin as fair as lilies, hair as golden as the corn. They knew that she was special from the moment she first cried. She was a mountain angel certified. She was her mama's baby, she was her daddy's pride. Good at home, at church, and school, and everything she tried. Everybody's darling, she led a charmed and peaceful life. The perfect mountain angel till he arrived. So high, it let her drop. She gave up everything for him that mattered in her life. All the others that had loved her, and she vowed to be his wife. She dreamed of bearing children in an ivy-covered house. The mountain angel sunshine turned to clouds. The wicked, handsome stranger
Well, he just left the way he came. He broke her heart and broke her mind. She never was the same. They say he was the devil, and he had come to steal her soul. And she never loved another, it is told. Now, they say she had a baby, and some say that it had died. They say it's just as well as it had been the devil's child. They say good conquers evil, but here evil won the prize. And so the mountain angel took to the wild. Together pieces of her life, they wouldn't fit beside the tiny grave deep in the woods is where she'd sit, talking to the baby, to herself, who knew for sure, possessed, they say, by Satan's insane lure. But high atop the mountain, for years they say she's seen, looking down upon the town where she had once been queen. She'd sneak around the playgrounds, watch the little children play. They'd see that crazy lady, then run away. They say she roamed these hills for years, wearing not a stitch. The once lovely mountain angel was now thought to be a witch. She made those wailing, mournful sounds that you could hear for miles, long after she'd laid down upon her baby's grave.
Some of you out there crying with me. That was you doing that. Was that you? Let's do it again. Oh, come on. You're sorry. be just like therapy. Let's get a good cry. Come on, we'll just do a couple of them just like that. You want to practice once more? Here we go. See, that feels good, don't it? That's just like going to therapy. Only thing better than a good cry is a good laugh. See, it ain't going to charge you nothing, though. Yeah, you'd have to pay hundreds of dollars for that if you went to, what do they call them, psychiatrists? Hadn't been in a while. Anyway, not that I ain't needed to go, but that was good. See, I like a good laugh and a good cry. Like I said, I didn't charge you nothing except what you already paid for your tickets. And I know that was a plenty, but I need the money. You know how much it costs to make a person look as cheap. Anyway, I appreciate that, and I know I feel better after a good cry. I feel like shining. How about you? I'm shining now.
Heaven let your light shine down. Oh, heaven let your light shine down. Oh.
so much. We're real proud of that song. I like to sing that. We recorded that last year on our Little Sparrow CD, and it won a Grammy, and we thought that was pretty good stuff. Thanks to you, of course. You're the one who buys them. I just sing them, but I appreciate you. Anyway, the title of the album, as I mentioned, was called Little Sparrow, and I wrote an old mountain song kind of patterned after a lot of the old world songs that we grew up here singing. And, of course, I like this particular kind of music. It's no one of them sad ones, but it's all right. You'll get over it. Some people just deserve to suffer, and I'm going to put you through it. Anyway, I do hope you like Little Sparrow. Little sparrow, little sparrow, precious, fragile, little thing, little sparrow, little sparrow, fly so and feels no pain. Now all ye maidens, heed my warning, never trust the hearts of men, for they will crush you like a sparrow, leaving you to never mend. They will vow to always love you, swear no love but yourn will do, and then they'll leave you for some other, break your little heart in two. Little sparrow, little sparrow, precious friend, little thing, little sparrow, little sparrow, fly so high it feels no pain. Oh, 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 oh. Now if I were a little sparrow, o'er these mountains I would fly, and I would find him and look into his lying eyes, and I would flutter all around him on my But I am not some little sparrow. I am just the broken dream of a cold, false-hearted lover and his evil, cunning scheme. Little sparrow, little sparrow, precious fragile little thing. Oh, the sorrow.
Well, personally, I think I should have called that song Little Pigeon, took a big dump on his head and flew to Rocky Top. What do you think? Looking for a moonshine steel. Strangers ain't come down from a Rocky Top, and some say they never will. Did you know corn don't grow at all on Rocky Top? The dirt's too rocky by far. And that's why all the folks on Rocky Top get their corn from a jar. Oh, Rocky Top, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee. In a pen. All I know is it's a dead burn pity. Life can't be simple again. Oh, the Rocky Top, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee.
Top. That is kind of like a national anthem in Tennessee. They play that now at all our UT games. It's great. Of course, I love Tennessee. I'm a Tennessee girl. How many folks we got here might be from this area? Yeah, quite a few. So you're proud of Tennessee. I've written a lot of songs about the Smoky Mountains where I grew up. I grew up over the mountains and in a family of 12. Well, we lived on a farm. I'm the farmer's daughter, the one they used to tell all them stories about. Well, a lot of them. But anyhow, we had a good life back there in the hills, and there's 12 of us kids. Had 6 girls and 6 boys. Mama had one on her and one in her, as long as I can remember. That's the truth. There's 8 kids younger than me. I have a brother, 2 brothers and a sister older than me, and then there's a whole house full underneath us there. We didn't have anything money could buy, but we had good stuff, things money don't buy anyhow. We always had something to eat, even if it wasn't what we wanted all the time. We had a roof over our head. We had songs to sing, and we had folks that loved us, and I've written many songs. And we had music. My mama's people were always very musical. So we'd sit around on summer afternoons out on the porch when all the work was done, or around the heater in the wintertime to pass time. That's the way Mom could keep us from fighting. She'd go sing something. Anyway, so I've written many songs about that. In fact, this little song right here kind of just sums up what a typical day might have been like.
In my Tennessee
a baby's side. In my Tennessee mountain home, crickets sing in the fields nearby. I remember sitting on the front porch on a summer afternoon, in a straight back chair on two legs, leaned against the wall. I'd watch the kids playing with June bugs on a string, and chase the glowing fireflies when evening shadows fall. In my Tennessee mountain home, life is peaceful as a baby's sigh. In my Tennessee mountain home, crickets sing in the fields nearby. Of course, now that was a typical day, and I have a lot of songs that I grew up with in my childhood that I wrote after I was grown. And a lot of people ask me, well, do you have a favorite song that you've written out of all those songs? I said, yeah, I do. I think my favorite song that I've ever written is not just because it's a song, but because it's very personal to me. It's really kind of a philosophy of life, really. And my mama made me a little coat one time out of scraps that she had sent. And a lot of people seem to relate to this song. After I recorded it, a lot of people said it really helped them, because I think a lot of people carry around a lot of hurt. They don't even realize that it's in there, and I think most people have been made fun of or lied of about something. It might not have been about a coat or even clothes, but something, a handicap or something. Somebody's made you feel bad about yourself, and that's a terrible, terrible hurt and feeling. But anyhow, this little song kind of lifted me out of that when I wrote it, and I want to do this to all the good mamas that we have out there. Thank you. That was mama. Not really. Back through the years I go wandering once again, back to the seasons of my youth, and I recall a box of rags someone gave us, and how my mama put the rags to use. Now there were rags of many colors, but every piece was small, and I didn't have a coat, and it was way down in the fall. Mama sewed the rags together, sewing every piece with love. She made my coat of many colors that I was so proud of. While mama sewed, she told a story from the Bible she had read, about a coat of many colors Joseph wore. And then she said, now I hope this coat will bring you good luck and happiness, and I just couldn't wait to wear it, and mama blessed it with a kiss. My coat of many colors that my mama made for me, made only from red, but I wore it so proudly. And although we had no money, I was rich as I could be in my coat of many colors mama made for me. So with patches on my breeches and holes in both my shoes, in my coat of many colors, well, I hurried off to school just to find the others laughing and making fun of me and my coat of many colors that Mom had made for me. And oh, I couldn't understand that, 'cause I felt I was rich, and I told them of the love that Mama sewed in every stitch. I even told them all that story that Mama told me while she sewed, and why my coat of many colors was worth more than all of their clothes. They didn't understand it, and I tried to make them see one is only poor made it just for me. Mom would be proud you liked that one. You know, when that song first became a hit, you know, as I was saying, it kind of lifted a lot of hurt off me. And I thought, you know, I'm not going to feel right about taking the first money, first royalty check, spend it on myself. I should buy something for Mom. Of course, this was back in the late 60s, early 70s that I had put this song out. So first chance I had, I left Nashville and went up to East Tennessee. And I said, Mama, get your pocketbook. I'm taking you to Knoxville. I'm going to buy you a new mink coat. She just looked at me funny. Of course, that was back when it was still okay to wear mink and nobody was thinking that much about it. But anyhow, she just looked at me funny. She said, a mink coat? Where in the world am I going to wear a mink coat around here to a cockfight? She said, you just give me that money. So I did. And of course, I'm sure she still had a house full of kids at that time, and she stretched that money pretty far, I know, because it's quite a bit of money for us, anyhow. But anyhow, it was thinking like that, and my mom was being able to help my dad that got us through, because like I say, raising a house full of kids like that, my dad was just a farmer, and daddy never was able to read and write, but he happened to be one of the smartest people I ever knew in spite of that fact. But he worked on a farm mostly, and as the kids started to multiply, well, he worked on construction. He'd get up way before daylight and work on the farm. Then he'd go work all day on a construction job, come back home, work way after dark. But anyhow, he was a very hard worker. My dad never told us he loved us. Never heard those words from my dad, but I don't ever remember time I didn't know it. We could see it in daddy's eyes. We could just hear it in his voice and just the way that he worked for us. He just wasn't a man that kind of get that stuff out like that, but we always knew it and we loved him dearly. But my dad passed away 2 years ago last month, and we miss him a lot. It's just like he's still here, really, because I'm always saying stuff. Sounds just like daddy doing stuff and looking in the mirror. I got my daddy's eyes without all this gook on him. But anyhow, I see him everywhere and think about him. I remember one time that when the family was multiplying, a lot of men folk around all the southern country or counties were going up to Detroit, Michigan, to work at the Ford plant. And my dad had a couple of brothers and friends that had gone up there, and a lot of country people were glad to get out of the mountains. They didn't like being hillbillies. They wanted to, you know, to do something else, and that was fine. But my dad never had been out of the Smoky Mountains where he was born and raised, and he loved the hills. So he thought, well, I'll try it, I reckon. And if I do all right, I'll bring my family to Detroit. Well, that lasted about 2 weeks. Daddy got so homesick, he almost died. He said, I'm going back to the Smoky Mountains, and I'll live and die there in them hills, raise my kids the best way I know how. And I wrote this about that time in my dad's life. So we'll dedicate it to all the hardworking folks out there. It's called Smoky Mountain Memories, and this is always for Daddy. You ought to go north, somebody told us, 'cause the air is filled with gold dust. And fortune falls like snowflakes in your hands. Now I don't recall who said it, but we'd spent our lives on credit, so we just headed out to find our promised land. Just poor Smoky Mountain farm folk with nothing more than high hopes. So we hitched our station wagon to a star. But our dreams all fell in on us, 'cause there was no land of promise. Lord, it's a struggle just keeping sight of who you are. Oh, and these northern nights are dreary. My old southern heart grows weary as I wonder how the old folks are back home. But I know that they all love me, and I know they're thinking of me. And Smoky Mountain memories keep me strong. You know, I've been thinking just a whole lot lately about what's been and what awaits me. It takes all I've got to give what life demands. Lord, you go insane if you give in to it. Life's a meal, and brother, I've been through it. I'm just thankful I'm creating with my hands. Oh, and these northern nights, they're dreary. These old southern eyes are teary as I wonder how the old folks are back home. But I'll keep leaning out. Smoky Mountain memories keep me strong. If I'll keep looking to the Father, He'll keep my head above the water. While these Smoky Mountain memories me strong. My home sweet home.
I wrote a lot of songs about my family and my childhood, but everybody in the Smoky Mountains was not kin to me. I know you're thinking that about now, but the ones that weren't, well, they seemed like it. They all seemed like family. We had a lot of good neighbors, and here's a song that I wrote about an old man that I grew up knowing, loved, and lived up in the woods not far from us. And of course, he had a bunch of old hunting dogs. He lived by himself. He had real long beard and real long hair. He looked kind of scary. Mama didn't like for me to go up there. She said he stunk. I said, well, Mama, we do too. And we did. But anyhow, she was afraid he had a drinking problem. And I'd heard her say that when I was a kid. You know how your little kids would just say anything they hear. So I asked him one day, I said, Applejack, do you have a drinking problem? He said, no. That's the easiest thing I've ever done. But anyhow, in all seriousness, I did love him, and he taught me a lot of stuff about a world outside the Smoky Mountains, because he'd been in the war, so he'd been on airplanes and ships and trains. I loved that about him, but mostly I loved the fact that he played the banjo, and he taught me, and years after he was gone, I wrote this about him. He lived by the apple orchard in this little old orchard shack. His real name was Jackson Taylor, but I called him Applejack. And old Applejack was loved by everyone he ever knew. Of course, Applejack picked apples, but he picked the banjo too. Play a song for me, Applejack. Applejack, play a song for me, and I'll sing. Almost every day, and we'd sit and we'd drink Applejack that old Applejack had made. Then he'd take his banjo down, and then he'd ask me if I'd sing. He would play the banjo when I'd play my tambourine. Play a song for me, Applejack, Applejack, play a song for me, and I'll sing. Play a song for me, Applejack, Applejack. Play a song, let your banjo ring. Come on down here, let's pick one.
just a kid, and now that I am grown, and all I have are these memories, 'cause old Applejack, well, he's gone. Oh, but he left me the banjo, and it always takes me back. Now every time I play it, I still hear Applejack. Now this is where you can sing along and clap your hands and sing anything you want to. Come on, I don't care what you say. Songs you can just get right into. Well, he didn't like it. He's leaving. I think you gotta go pee, ain't you? Well, we'd all like to go, can we? Oh, no, he's gonna be mad at me forever for embarrassing him. Well, anyway, you come on back, though, when you're done, okay? We'll wait on you. Anyway, I want to ask you folks a question. How many of you folks out there are married? Woo! That's a lot of people. How many of you are happily married? How many of you wouldn't dream of answering that second question? Oh, well, I ain't trying to start no trouble because I don't want to be responsible for a D-I-V-O-R-C-E. Tell him what that spells. Anyway, I've been married 36 years myself to the same old guy. And I'm sick of it. Anyway, but it's my own dang fault. I asked him to marry me. Tall as a sycamore tree. He's real smart with a real big heart, and he's gonna marry me. Oh, he's gonna marry me. We're gonna go to town. We're gonna buy us a real good car. We're gonna drive around. We'll hold hands, touch and hug. He talks so sweet to me.
Well, I know a lot about love and stuff.
He's done kissed me on the mouth, and he's gonna marry me.
smell it. You mind if I get me a sip of water? I'll be right back. It's right over there. Spring's right over here.
Love you, Ollie.
I told you to wait in the truck. They never listen to you. Anyway, I'm ready to go again now. Yeah. Anyway, that was fun. Are you having a good time out there? Well, I'm sorry they got so many lights on you, but they're doing a special, I guess they told you. So you're going to be on TV, so at least you're a pretty crowd. Lord, we had some ugly people here last night. Not really. We had a good crowd last night, but they didn't like the lights in their face either. But I didn't know you was going to be all lit up, but I'm glad I could see you. That's all right. It won't show that much. And like I say, at least you know you look good. You know, we've been having a lot of success with our records here lately. And people say, well, what do you call this music you're doing? I said, well, I'm doing exactly what I've always done since I started singing. I'm doing a little bit of bluegrass now, a little more than had been. And of course, we're doing some mountain music and country music. And I said, well, I don't know that we have to put a new label on it, but we are a bunch of hicks. So I guess we could call it Hick Hop. Of course, they got all that hip-hop. You've heard that song, Who Let the Dogs Out? Probably, ain't you? Yeah. Well, we thought about calling our latest CD, Who Let the Hogs Out? Good Lord! Don't take much to stir them up!
Who let the hogs out?
Hey! Now, we don't need any more of that. So we didn't call it that. We decided that we'd call it something else. As a matter of fact, we decided that we'd call it Halos and Horns. But you know, it's a hard thing, this Halos and Horns. It's like about people trying to choose right from wrong. I mean, we all want to be good, don't we? But we're usually just a little too bad to be real good and too good to be real bad. So it's kind of like we got a little devil, you know, on this shoulder here. And he's just telling you in this ear how much fun it is to be bad. Then we got a little angel over here on this right shoulder, whispering in your ear, saying how good it is to be good. Because I'm not going to say which way I've been leaning lately, but hey, I see a few of you are leaning this way too. Don't try to straighten up now. I already saw you. But anyhow, the good thing is, it's never too late to get on the right side of the angels. It just ain't as much fun. Anyway, this is called Halos and Horns.
You know.
on your lip gloss. I got some chewing gum and candy, some magazines and snacks, some starting over money that I've been holding back. I got a change of clothes and notepad to write a letter back to say so long. I got a one-way ticket saying goodbye. Unhappy and tolerate the pain and separate and have me taking half of everything. Well, I'm leaving your possessions, left on the goodbye train, left you song. I stayed up all night trying to figure out all the stuff I was going to leave him. So I had fun. Anyway, I hope you like that. Anyway, this next song, I guess everybody's had a broken heart. I mean, everybody, if you've been married as long as we say we have, well, you know, we go through stuff. I think not many people ever get out of this world without getting hurt now and then. It might be a different kind of hurt, but they say in Nashville, if you're going to be a songwriter and you're going to write songs, if you want to have a hit, make it hurt. Well, this next one is pretty sad. It hurts. I don't know if it'll be a hit, but I like singing it, and I hope you like it. It's called Dagger Through the Heart. Oh, you. I picture you. car? Looks like a 57 Chevrolet, doesn't it? Without wheels. That is beautiful. I spent a lot of time in the back of a 57 Chevrolet. Back seat. Oh, not that. I was just little then. It was my brother's car. I was back there with the back seat out looking for loose change where he'd been back there. Anyway, I do think this is a pretty guitar. And I get to play the wah-wah on this one, so I drug this all the way up here just to do this.
And one, two.
If a picture paints a thousand words, then why can't I paint you? The words will never show the you I've come to know. And if a face could launch a thousand ships, then where am I to go? There's no one home but you. You're all that's left me to. And when my love for life is running dry, you come and pour your spell on me. If I could be two places that one time, I'd be with you tomorrow and today, beside you all the way. And if the world should stop revolving, spinning slowly down to die, I'd spend the end with you. And when the world was through, then one by one the stars would all go out. Then you and I would simply fly away. And words, then why can't I paint you? It's 'cause my words would never show the you I've come to know. And one by one the stars will all go out, but you and I will simply fly. Saying something about the king, and there were peasants singing and drummers drumming, and the archer split the tree. There was a fanfare blowing to the sun, there was floating on the breeze. Just look at Mother Nature on the run in the 21st century. Look at Mother Nature. with the full moon in my eyes. I was hoping for replacement when the sun burst through the sky. There was a band.
Some years ago. In fact, I used my fingernails to write a song called 9 to 5 while we was on the set. Yeah. Well, Jane Fonda and Lily Tomlin were biting their nails. I just a picking mine. Well, I tumble out of bed and stumble to the kitchen. I pour myself a cup of ambition. I yawn and stretch and try to come to life. Well, I jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Starts jumping with folks like me on the job from 9 to 5. Yeah, working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taking and no giving. They just use your mind. They never give you credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5 for service and devotion. You would think that I would deserve. Dream just to watch them shatter. You're just a step on the boss man's ladder. But you got dreams he'll never take away. You're in the same boat with a lot of your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in. Tide's gonna turn and it's all gonna roll your way. I just know it. Working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taking and no giving. They just use your mind. They never give you credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it.
man, working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living. You're on television, remember? You're gonna look pretty puny if you ain't singing. A working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living. Barely getting by. It's all taking and no giving. They just use your mind. They never give you credit. It's enough to drive you. Oh, pardon me, Farmer. I was kidding. Well, you're doing good. I appreciate that. I'm glad you like that. You probably know this next one, too. This next one is a song about another woman trying to steal another woman's man. Lord, if somebody tried to steal some of the guys I've been out with, it'd be more like petty theft. Anyway, this is about an old redheaded gal trying to steal my husband. Early on when we first got married, oh, she was absolutely beautiful. She was tall and skinny and redheaded, long legs, everything I wanted and didn't have. She was a knockout. She didn't get him. But I look at him every once in a while, and boy, I wish she had. Her name was Jolene. In fact, I saw a couple of drag queens out there that came in earlier. And they said, are you going to sing Jolene? I said, yes, I am. One of them looked more like me than I ever will. And the other one was prettier than any of us girls will ever be. So this is for the drag queens, and it's for you. Skin and eyes of emerald green. Your smile is like a breath of spring. Your voice is soft like summer rain. Why can I compete with you, drag queen? He talks about you in his sleep. There's nothing I can do to keep from crying when he calls your name, your name. Oh, but I can easily understand how you could easily take my man, but you don't know what he means to me, Jolene. Jolene, 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 Jolene. Oh, I'm begging of you, please don't take my man. Jolene, 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 Jolene. Please don't take him just because. Choice of men, I could never love again, cause he's the only one for me, Jolene. I had to have this talk with you. My happiness depends on you and whatever you decide to do, Jolene. Everybody, Jolene, Jolene, Jolene. Enjoyed that. I said, it's a good thing I was a woman. I'd have definitely been a drag queen. As much as I like wearing all this gaud. Anyway, I like singing a cappella. Of course, and I'm glad you like those songs, too. I like, you know, like singing with you like when we're doing that. And you know those. You know them all by heart, don't you? Like 9 to 5 and Jolene. But there's a whole bunch. Those are the ones that did good. You've never heard some of the ones that I wrote that didn't make it. Like, let's see. Well, I bought this sexy lingerie thinking that I might get some action out of you. But every time I take it off, you put it on letter in it too.
And there's a whole bunch of others like that. Like I lost my honey bunny on a bad hair day. Or I got the biscuits in the oven, now get your buns in bed. Anyway, like I say, I like singing songs just by myself. And you were good when we were singing by ourselves without the music. So people can sing without music. They call that a cappella. That's a big word, ain't it, for singing with no music? So I thought I'd ask Richard and Randy and Ken to come down, and we're going to do a little medley of some songs that you might miss if we didn't do them in the show at all, but we don't have time to do everything, so we thought we'd just kind of condense them. You want to drag me up a chair there? See if I can get in these little tight breeches. Okay, I'm on. So hit us a note there, Richard.
Okay, here we go.
Pitchfork, pipe, whatever. You boys okay with that note? Mm-hmm. Well, let's go then.
2, 3, 4.
Islands. Islands.
Islands. In the stream, that is what we are, no one in between. How can we be wrong? Sail away to another world, and we rely on each other, uh-huh. From one lover to another, uh-huh. Giving me a heart attack when you waltz right in here looking like that. Why'd you come in here looking like that? Why'd you come in here looking like that? Two doors down, they're laughing and drinking and having a party.
But two doors down, they're not aware that I'm around.
Here I am, crying my heart out, feeling sorry,
but they're having a party just two doors down. That's right, we're having a party two doors down.
Yeah!
How about them boys? They're good acapellers, ain't they? Of course, when we were trying to work the show up, we knew we was going to be doing it on TV. We thought, well, we needed something a little special. So the boys said, why don't we take one of the songs and maybe do it on fast speed? That might be fun.
Yeah.
I thought, well, I guess we'll try it. So we decided we'd do Two Doors Down on 78 speed, we used to call it. Now we just call it fast speed,
fast, I guess. Speed.
Are you boys as wound up as you was when we practiced?
Oh, sure, yeah.
Two doors down the level and drinking and having a party. Two doors down the level where the wrong man. Here I am, trying my heart out, feeling sorry. Having a party, it's a two doors down. That's right, we're having a party. It's a two, 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 two. We're hung up here. Lord, ain't it amazing what people will do for attention? too into doing that. But, well, it was fun when we was doing it, wasn't it? Well, anyway, we hope you enjoyed that. I guess you could say, yeah, we're still crazy after all these years. Now get back to your cages. Okay. Now, when you came in tonight, I had left some words in your seat so you could sing along with me on this. Did you find them? You sitting on them? Oh, get them. Sing anyway. They'll just sound like crap. Were you sitting on? Oh, they gave them to you at the door, didn't they? Anyway, so somewhere down in this song, well, you can sing along with me if you want to. You probably read them. But anyhow, just later on the song. This is a song that I wrote for the Irish. So I got to play the penny whistle on this one. And we hope you like it. And you can sing whenever you feel like it. We Irish love to sing, we Irish love to dance, we Irish love to party whenever we get the chance. We have a lot of troubles, but we have a lot of soul. We'll drink a pint of Guinness and forget about our woes. Aye, 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 we Irish are the best. We love our myths and stories, we love a mournful song. We love our joyful music and a good old sing-along. We love our penny whistle, illan pipes and air barong. We Irish love our football, our heroes and our home. Can I get a big yell? We love to sing, we Irish love to dance, we Irish love to party whenever we get the chance. We have a lot of troubles, but we have a lot of soul. We'll drink a pint and Guinness and forget about our woes. Aye, 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 we Irish are the best. We Irish love St. Paddy, we love to celebrate. And nothing suits us better than an all-out green parade. Green beer and hats and jackets, green dresses, shirts and ties. And nothing could be brighter than the light in Irish eyes. We got a pub on every corner and a church to worship in. We party hard, then pray the Lord forgive us of our sins. We rid ourselves of grief and guilt, relieve our troubled hearts. I know God loves the Irish and accepts us as we are. We Irish love to sing, we Irish love to dance, we Irish love to party whenever we get the chance. We have a lot of troubles, but we have a lot of soul. We'll drink a pint of Guinness and forget about our woes. Aye, 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 we Irish are the best. Aye, 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 we Irish are the best. Now I bet you folks didn't know that I'm part Irish. I am. Which part of me do you think looks Irish? This part? I agree. So I'm gonna play a little solo. Are you ready? Here's your chorus. You got it down there. Oh, we Irish love to sing. We Irish love to dance. We Irish love to party whenever we get the chance. We have a lot of troubles, but we have a lot of soul. We'll drink wine and Guinness and forget about our woes. Oh, appreciate you. You weren't singing that much. Was you bashful? I'm gonna get another drink of water. All that glitters is gold, and she's buying a stairway to heaven. When she gets there, she knows if the stores are all closed. With a word, she can get what she came for.
You don't know.
And anyway, thank you again for being so nice, and I appreciate it. Hi, Kins. How you doing over there?
If I should stay, well, I would only be in your way. So I'm gone, but I know that I'll think of you each step of the way.
But above all this,